Hello everyone, I am Taureor and welcome to my newest Hearts of Iron 4 video. Today we're going to play as the Netherlands and explore their new focus tree. Well, the focus tree is not that new anymore, but I haven't played it yet, so it is new to me. I have planned this out a little bit, but not completely. We might need to adapt to how the situation develops. And what's going to be our goal? Well, I'm thinking of the English Channel, like in Europa Universalis 4, dominating trade here and so on. And for that, well, we'd need to dominate the region as well. We'll see how that goes. Regular difficulty, I'm on mode, historical focuses, as always, let's go. Now, as the Netherlands, we start with a lot of very negative modifiers. One good modifier and five bad ones. First, we have a horrible leader. We are neutral. We are shell-shocked spectators of the Great War. We have the Krisisjaren, which would be like the years of crisis, I guess, and a weak government. So we're terrible, but we can remedy that. Let's start by forming a new government and work on getting some troops in the field. This one, because it's the smallest, we start with just 8 units and we want a total of 3 full armies for now. Maybe 2 full armies for now. So that's 48 plus 6 from a leader, minus 8 from that we already have, so that's 46 units we need to train. Priority, like this, should work nicely. Production, just infantry weapons. Construction, civilian factories, dockyards. Convoys, buy some steel. Research, let's do machine tools. Let's research. And also mass assault, because I like mass assault. Now, we don't have a lot of manpower. We only have 8 divisions and enough manpower to support that. But, fortunately, we also have our greatest treasure, the Dutch East Indies, and there are almost 1 million manpower pool. So what we're gonna do is go here, do a colonial template, and they have an infantry division and a garrison. Let's copy the infantry division. It is 18 with infantry. It's gonna be perfect for what we need. Switch all the units we have to that and exercise them. Also, gather up all our fleets and bring them here. Or here, doesn't really matter. Okay, that's it. Speed the game up. Fuel could become a problem. We might need to buy oil. And we're gonna be deploying these guys ahead of time, switching them to the colonial template and training them up in the field. Switch to colonial template. Add to an army exercise. After forming the new government, we have 4 possible paths. We can go fascist, we can go communist, we can go non-aligned, or we can go with democracy. This time I've planned a fascist run. If I revisit this, I'll probably try out the non-aligned path, but we'll see about that in the future. Forming new government removes the weak government thing, which gives us more political power. Let us continue down this path and do gateway to Europe. And we have a new, also bad, leader. Keep deploying, switching, and training. Ethiopia was the next. Gateway to Europe unlocks some decisions that let us lean towards the Brits, the Germans, or remain in the middle. Well, if we cave to the Germans, we can go fascist. If we cave to the British, we stick to democracy. And if we stay in the middle, we can lean towards communism or non-aligned. We're going to cave to the Germans. So we need to do the placate the Germans decision until they have at least 25 trade influence. Might go for 30 just to be safe. In the meantime, let us abandon the gold standard. I'm not spending my political power. We will need it soon. Germany dominates Dutch trade negotiations. Let's keep repeating this decision over and over again. Need to get it to 25. I will want to go to a full army group a bit later, but for now, 2 full armies should be sufficient. Mass assault. Yeah, and I forgot to do the decisions, of course. Damn it. Well, I didn't forget for long. We need to have at least 25 and also 15 more than the Brits. So it should be okay. Right, one more. And then we go into the cave to the Germans focus. That should suffice, at least for now. Right, now we cave to the Germans. And also observe this, because if Britain goes to 10, then we have to placate the Germans again, because the focus will pause. But we also don't want to waste political power unnecessarily. We're about to finish. Even if the Brits get a bit of influence, it won't matter. And we've caved to the Germans, which opens up the fascist paths for us. Let's do Volk and Vaterland. That will unlock a fascist demagogue and help us transition to fascism. Deploy units, 2 armies in the field. Add them to an army group, and this guy is going to be our field marshal, because he's level 4 and a brilliant strategist, which is just perfect. And this guy is a skilled staffer, which means 30 units for him. Focus complete. Let's hire a fascist demagogue and overturn military budget cuts. We open up political discourse, and wait, we're having an election in 37, which will help us switch to fascism very quickly. We're following this path because we need to get rid of a shell-shocked spectator of the Great War. Prepare the inundation lines. Spanish Civil War? Did I say when it started? I don't remember. Anyway, there's anarchists now. We could theoretically intervene in that and attack nationalist Spain when they're about to win, because they usually win, but it's not really worth it. France and Britain announce alliance. Now, we're not going to do a focus. Why? Well, because in less than a month we're going to be fascist and we'll have access to more focuses. And here's the election event. See, we can get 10% fascism support. We are at 30% fascist support at the moment. So what we need to do is discredit the government. That brings us to 35 and 9 for communists. And now we're also going to ban communism. It costs quite a lot of political power, but it speeds us up. With 39 fascism, I guess I could have done that in reverse order. Yeah, doesn't matter. Now we get extra fascism from this. And we are at 49.74. Now, wait a few more days and we should be able to do the referendum. Here we go. Old national referendum. Boom, we're fascist. We can now start one of these focuses. Also, I would like to do Germany is the greater threat. Or we could do protect against Britain, but we don't want to antagonize them. But for that, we need 10% world tension, which is difficult. We could start justifying a war goal on someone, for example. Let's justify a war goal on Ireland. That's going to be just 4% world tension. Not enough for the focus, probably. Oh, maybe it is enough. No, almost enough. Doesn't matter. World tension will go up soon. In the meantime, we can do strength over blood. Why Ireland? Well, it's a great point to attack Britain from. I forgot to buy steel. That's a problem. So I do have a lot of dockyards. I guess I could be making some ships as well. One of the cheapest ships. That should do. Could have started that at the very beginning. But I guess it doesn't matter that much. Chinese United Front forms. Hindenburg survived. Interesting. Aggressive assault. And we can't afford more for now. Soon. Soon we will. I'm getting military factories from my puppet. Let's get these ships into one fleet or whatever it's called and give them an admiral. We're invited to join the Axis. No thanks. Not now. Still not enough world attention for any of these. It's fine, although it would be nice to get them early. The Netherlands first. I could theoretically start justifying another war goal on someone else temporarily just to buff the world tension, but that could result in guarantees happening, which is risky. Once again, conserving political power. Ah, see, Japan attacked. We're 17 days in. I suppose I could switch now. How much is it exactly? See, because we want to do war on pacifism soon. Yeah, okay, we're not that far in. We just lose a couple of days. Let's do Germany is a greater threat. I should have waited with that. No matter, wasted just a little bit of political power. How long until we can attack Ireland? Long. Next up, war on pacifism. With that, we'll be able to remove the shell-shocked spectator of the Great War bit. It takes a long time to do it, but we'll be able to. And then we can do the United Netherlands focus. Could use more guns. I guess I'll work on military factories. I do prefer to stack a lot of civilian ones early on, but we need the guns now. We'll just finish the four factories and then do military ones. Computing machine. War on pacifism complete. Good. Now let's go back to the Netherlands first and start enacting the decisions that will remove pacifism from us. Establish there are three of those decisions, and the outcome is the same. You need to take them five times. Each time it's 60 days. 60 days, is it? Yes. And at the end, you no longer have the modifier. But they cost different amounts. This costs 25 political power and reduces our stability very significantly. This one reduces our political power gain slightly, reduces factory and dockyard output, and increases communism at the end. And this one reduces political power quite a lot. This one is the least painful. Let's use it repeatedly. Communism will not be a problem since we have a fascist demagogue and he'll counter that. I'm saving up political power. We'll want to go to war economy later and maybe get an infantry expert, but we're in no rush to do it now. Also, caving to the Germans gave us free trade, which is the best trade. Let's have a closer look at Ireland. How are we doing? Oh, 40 days until the war. Let's start preparing our orders. Naval invasion of Ireland. It could fail. They just have one port, and if we fail to take it, it could be problematic, but I think we'll succeed, right? 10 naval invasions. That's how many we're allowed to do. Now, the ships. The patrol. That should be sufficient for the naval invasion, and you guys launch when ready. I guess before we attack Ireland, I will hire the infantry expert. And should I get the offense expert as well? He is expensive, and I'm not going to have a lot of political power. I guess I can afford him. Let's make sure the attack is quick and decisive. Pity about the political power, though. What is this ship doing here? Oh, that's the new ships. Let's add them to the fleet. Also, make sure to keep doing these decisions. I have to monitor that. You know what? I could just unselect all the other decisions to make sure when this is available, I'll get a pop-up. That's a roundabout way of doing it, but it works. Dublin is probably defended. Well, almost certainly defended, but perhaps we'll be able to lure them away from it or something like that. Infantry, illnesses, and war goals ready. Let's declare war on Ireland. Don't call any allies because we don't have any allies. And observe. They are on the move. Good. Netherlands first complete. Oh, right. Let's not forget to do these decisions. Pro-war labor indoctrination. In the meantime, let's implement the plan. That will give us a better economy and more manpower. Dublin's under attack, but we have landed around it. Right, let's try and get these guys killed. And we've landed in Dublin. Perfect. Well, the fact that we've landed in Dublin means we have the only important province in all of this, which is Dublin itself, because it has a port. The rest is of secondary importance. So all the troops that are at sea shall be redirected to Dublin. And you reinforce. We can't lose the port. Also, be aggressive. Ireland is much weaker than we are, so, you know, we're gonna crush them. And the port is safe. Well, these armies are not, clearly. I made a mistake, but it's just two units. The important part is that we keep the port. Maybe you can still save them. Probably not, though. No, we can't. They're dead. Oh, well, I'm willing to make that sacrifice. Be super aggressive. I guess I shouldn't have stopped the other naval invasions because they would have pulled the enemy attention away from us here. I can still change that. Cancel orders and plan small naval invasions with the guys we already have here. A small mistake that we can quickly correct. And maybe even we'll win instantly once these invasions launch because all the enemy forces will be here. That's letting us just take all the remaining stuff. We'll say, okay, go. 7 days until they launch. And the rest of this army can just sit in Dublin and enhance its defense. plans. Launching Anschluss of Austria. And they're being invited into the Axis. Are you guys actually launching or not? No, because you're actually moving. Let's stop them so that they can launch. That's better. Now, these troops are at risk, but again, it should be worth it. By just sending them to take all the provinces here, we will cut these guys off from supply and kill them quickly. And also, well, also these will be easily taken over as they're surrounded. See, now these guys should have no supply. And we're through. Great. Get connected quickly. Ireland is taken care of. Let's just annex all of it. We lost 2 units. A pity. Now time to execute the next steps of our plan. And did I forget to take the decision again? No, this time I did not. Let's take it again. It's time for you guys to move back to the Benelux, because you're going to be conquering Belgium soon. Well, not that soon. It's going to take a while. Still, oh, I forgot to promote him. That would have made things a bit easier. We've implemented the program. That moves us to early mobilization, which is not that great. I want war economy. But for war economy, we'll need to wait until we get enough political power. In the meantime, we could do taking back French Flanders, but that's just a war goal on France, which we don't need. We want a united Netherlands, but we need to enact these decisions 5 times before that's available. And, well, I guess we'll do Jugdstrom, this one. Like the Storm of the Young, I guess? Probably. Maybe a young storm. Whatever. The fleet can rest. Your order is going to be to just patrol this area, but for now, you can rest. How are we doing on logistics? We need to deploy more armies, but right now, I should probably be better off if I just have these ones well supplied. Also, let's make sure all of them are trained up. Actually, maybe modify them to a 20 width. We have access to bicycle battalions, which is wonderful. However, they also require support equipment, which is less wonderful. Let's start working on the better guns. Should probably train 2 more units, just to make sure the army is full. People's army. But I forgot to take the decision again. God damn it. It's gonna delay me, and I can't allow myself to be delayed too much. We can't do this focus yet, and I don't really have interest in this one. So, let's move over here and get some doctrine bonuses. We're being invited into the Axis. Not yet, but instead, I would like to go to war economy. Oh, I don't have enough political power to do this. God damn it. Just have to wait. Right, a last time. The national spirit will be removed after 60 days. I guess I will not select a new focus, because we want to get the war goal on Belgium and Luxembourg as quickly as possible. New supreme commander. And we're going to also modernize our infantry equipment, but should we do it just yet? No, because we want to spend that bonus on this technology here. For that to happen, we need to already be researching improved infantry equipment too. Also, I was supposed to wait to do the United Netherlands, wasn't I? So let's do that. Actually, I can do anti-communist raids and anti-democratic raids to get some more stability. Let's do anti-communist raids. Stability is quite important. We have quite a lot of political power now because I'm not doing a focus currently. Fort International, and one day we're finally rid of the bad modifier. Let us do United Netherlands. Let's also see if they don't get guaranteed, but I haven't really generated a lot of world attention, so they shouldn't be. Munich Agreement. Czechoslovakia slowly disappearing. Oh, right, we changed the general thing. He is a good field marshal for defense, a brilliant field marshal for defense. However, we're not going to be defending ourselves, we're going to be attacking people. Focused on building military factories now. I maybe should have done that a bit earlier. We do need the equipment. We should be able to crush Belgium quite easily. Although it is not a certain quick victory, it should be a quick victory. Do I have any planes? 12. Well, those 12 will have to suffice. I guess I could launch a naval invasion behind their lines. I'm sure I have more troops, but then again, if we didn't get a port, those troops would die. Any guarantees? No guarantees. Good. United Netherlands complete. We have the war goal. Let's declare war immediately on both Belgium and Luxembourg. What's our next focus? We could get taking back our colonies. That's a war goal on the other allies. And with this, we also get some extra factory output and war support. Could be helpful. Or alternatively, we can modernize our infantry. I guess I'll just modernize our infantry. So, let's go. Attack. Looking good so far. We should be able to break through in Antwerpen. And elsewhere as well, apparently. Good. At least. Wonderful. That is a pretty easy victory. Belgium capitulates. Take all states. Now, Luxembourg. Everyone just go to Luxembourg. They had a soldier. Take all states. Glorious. Now, it's November 38. We own Ireland and the entire Benelux. And some stuff elsewhere as well. What will we do with it? Well, of course, we're going to repudiate the Treaty of London. Boom. We're now, what are we? Leo Belgicus. Okay, that means way more manpower. Core states and factories should increase momentarily as well. Oh, right, let's do anti-democratic raids too. That's extra stability for us. And with that, we can start our preparation to beat up the Brits and the French, so that it can be the Dutch Channel. 50 factories. Glorious. Now let's go to a full army group. Now, how much manpower do the Dutch East Indies have? 1 more army worth of manpower. And then we'll do 2 with our own. And then, I guess we could do bicycles. Can we afford that? Yes, I think we can, actually. No, first let's make sure we have guns for them, and then we can give them bicycles. So, 3 more armies. There's gonna be 72 of these guys. So, 36 twice. I might actually be better off not getting war goals against France and Britain, because then we can quickly join the Axis and launch our attacks almost immediately. immediately, and they will not be ready for it. Yeah, I think we're not going to get these war goals on purpose. I actually have a lot of guns. I'm pretty sure I can afford those bicycles. Let's see, if I were to switch you guys to bikes completely, just create a new division template. Bicycle battalions. Bicycle battalions everywhere. I will not have enough military experience to do this for both the normal and the colonial ones, at least for now. Right, 20 with bicycle battalions. I guess I could add recon and artillery to them as well. I should have some artillery from what we've taken. Right, this will have to do. Bicycle battalion. Let's just call it bikes. Oh, better yet, bikers. And we have the better guns researched. Good. Let's start equipment 3. Then we can use the bonus we're researching to get even better guns. Need to buy a lot of steel from the Germans. And that's good. We want to strengthen the Germans. And secret staff talks. We don't need that. But I'm curious what it does. I've never seen this in action. So I'm actually going to take the decision. Deploy units. Once again, I am being invited into the Axis. Not yet. It's strategically better to do it like right before we start fighting the French and the British. Then they'll be unprepared. I'm going to conserve some manpower to see if I can use it for the secret talks. And if not, I'll go for better conscription. Deploy all the remaining units. We have 5 full armies. 3 of them I'm just going to make into bikers. And let's see where we stand on equipment. It's a lot, but it is doable, I think. Support equipment will be the most difficult. I guess 2 units of bikers will have to suffice. You'll be the colonial one instead. Yeah, that's a bit better. Make sure to exercise them all. Generals. 1, 2, 3. Infantry offensive. Secret staff talks. Okay. Do we want bonuses for land doctrine? I guess I do. Yes. Let's do that. And have a look at these talk decisions. That's a lot. Okay, this is preparing for defeat. So no. Interesting. I can exchange political power for equipment. Political power is usually worth more, though. This is defensive. With this we buy a bonus for land doctrine. Intriguing. Okay, so exchange intelligence data seems to be the offensive option. We're going to do exchange intelligence data with Germany, but it seems to only last for 180 days, so let's do it right before the attack. I think I need one more army just to defend my ports. Let's create one more. Fate of Czechoslovakia. Good. How is that equipment going? Let's see if I can get equipment from Germany. It's not going to be a lot, and it costs political power, so it's not really worth it. But let's see if they would accept. Refused. Oh, bastards. I almost forgot. There's something very important I need to do. I need to research better naval invasions, and I might not have enough time to do it. Oh well, we'll just have to make do with the invasions we have. Planning now. Sadly, just 10. Lessons from the last war complete. Now there is not much left for us to do. Sure, this can be useful, but if we have a war goal against the Allies, they might get suspicious of us. So let's instead continue the public works. No, actually, let's get some more dockyards. I know this would have been more effective if I did that earlier, but they can help us a bit. Alright, I was supposed to deploy more units. Let's do that. Elite joins Axis. Perfect. And once the war starts, so will I. As the equipment? Not good, actually. Not good at all. We don't have enough support stuff for the bikes. These bikes need to not be bikes. And again, are they as fast? They don't have the equipment. Probably not. Let's just switch them to regular infantry. Make sure it's 20 width. Pity. I'm so hopeful about the bikes. Yeah, well, we'll keep just one army of the bikes so that they can get into France quickly. You will use my own manpower. And I need to update my conscription. Just garrison the stuff. Well, actually, we're going to be reserve units. Equipment is not that important for defense. Coast and ports. Extensive conscription. Germany is about to attack. We should get ready as well. Let us exchange intelligence data with Germany. Well, they must approve the agreement. Okay, we'll do that at the moment of us joining their alliance, which we're about to do anyway. Well, I guess we'll continue the public works now. And stop the training. It's too late for that. Want me to join your faction? Yes, you do. Good. Infantry offensive complete. Poland refuses a German ultimatum. Oh, join. And they apparently are just fighting against us, but it's not going to come to pass. Let's send the fleet out. Let's wait until the war is actually declared. Germany attacked Poland. Okay, let's give the French a moment to get their troops out of our face. Poland joins the Allies. Sure. Just a moment longer. Okay, I think we're good to go. Orders. Same for you. Attack aggressively. Get in position. A bit faster, please. Right. It's going to have to suffice. We're good in Britain. Germany, let me join your faction. Let's then pause for a moment. We are now in the faction. Let us exchange intelligence data. Will that work if I'm at war? Or do I need to wait for them to accept? I'm not going to wait for them to accept. I'm going to join your wars. Go. Let us conquer France and Britain. Quickly. Accepted. I should now be at war with France. Send the bikes to Paris. Did the naval invasion launch? It seems to not have launched, because we don't have the naval supremacy. That's actually terrible. Okay, guys, run away to port. This one. We'll reinitiate this a bit later. What are we doing in France? Might have been unlucky and just encountered their fleet. They agree to exchange intelligence. Good. I wonder if it'll still apply. I mean, the bonus. I don't see it anywhere. Well, we are in France. We are deep in France. Get me all those victory points. France is mine. mine. Give me Paris. The Netherlands have taken Paris. Oh, and we have Belfast as well. Do we know how many ships we have? We know supremacy. That doesn't tell me much. We'll wait for France to capitulate, then we'll try this again. France is almost capitulating. But they have also brought up a defense. Well, we did reach Paris. That's something. Oh, there are naval battles here. Perhaps I can just compare the numbers on the supremacy. This is 20 to 30,000. This is 8 to 17,000. Maybe that's enough. Let's see. 29.2. Okay, well, I have 5,000 supremacy. Go back. Don't want to fight them right now. You can probably count on the Italians to come and help eventually. Of Nanjing, what's my participation? Just 8%. I've taken most of France for you. What the hell? Well, let's call our subject. Perhaps the Brits will delegate some fleets down there. Okay, you guys go balanced now. And the bikes will actually relocate over to Italy. By initiating the fighting on that side, we may get some extra score. For Warsaw. Okay, do we know their supremacy? They seem to be guarding against my ships. What if I relocated them? Will they get caught? They seem to be fine. Just stay here for now. Their supremacy seems to be unaffected by my ships. I will just wait for France to be done for. Johnson M44. Time to research. Oh, there's a battle. Just convoys. Will the Germans bring out some navy here? It sure would be helpful. Be aggressive. Every little bit of territory we take could lead to France capitulating. Actually, being balanced seemed to work better. Let's do the economic fixes. I have no organization and terrible attrition because there's too many troops here. God damn it. Alright, let's take one of these armies out of here. They should be relatively safe traveling. Relatively. Some should survive. And always, you know, send them from here over to Britain. Construction 4 with a bonus. France capitulated and I got most of it. Glorious. Now, that's gonna be a lot of factories, isn't it? So how about that naval supremacy now? It is not in my favor. Death of Rudolf Hess. Right, so one of these armies is just gonna garrison all of this. Namely ports. And the others are gonna get ready for some naval invasions. Let's see if I can succeed now. Supremacy of 29%. That's not gonna work. I need support. I need support from the Italians. Come on, Italians, give me support for a moment. This should work if I just do patrol. There's a lot of them here. Maybe don't engage. Dock at the port. Doesn't look too good, does it? That is unfortunate. I need the Germans to do something about it. Or the Italians. Just need someone to help me with this. I might just need to get more dockyards. More submarines. More submarines because they're cheap. This is gonna take some time. I can research the better naval invasions. Then maybe we can do them all over. From here, from here, from here. Maybe at some point they will drop their guard. Norway has joined. I wonder. They'll move troops to defend Norway. Or rather, ships. And Denmark has joined as well. I suppose I could help with those. Launch naval invasions and such. But I'll just let the Axis handle it. We only have 9% participation. That's very low. They do hold most of France, so that's something. Enemy supremacy is falling a bit. If they move their troops a bit, I'll be set. I don't need war propaganda. I have 100% war support in an offensive war. But we could get some more stability. Denmark capitulates. I still get supremacy. 40%. Nope. Almost there. I just need a moment so that my naval invasion is going to launch. We'll do it eventually. Friendly supremacy. There's some friendly ships here. Oh, that's the moment. See? Enemy supremacy, 2,000. My supremacy, 2,000 and a bit. And soon it'll be more. Which means naval invasions should be launching. Here we go. Britain's ours. Almost. We no longer have the supremacy, but it doesn't matter since the invasions are on the way. That is, if we can get at least one port. That'll make sense. If we can't, it's pointless. Can I get Portsmouth? Probably not, but let's try. Can help with Cardiff. Doesn't look too good, does it? Okay, here we go. We have landed in a port. Perfect. Go reinforce it. You guys. There. Quickly. Just one army for now. Why are you not moving? Be super aggressive and go. Yes, there's risk, whatever. It's life and death. Don't worry about it. Landed next to Cardiff and Bristol. Try helping Cardiff. Scapa flow might be ours in a moment. I do have two more armies standing by to reinforce. I think we're about to get Cardiff. And we actually got Liverpool. Oh, right. I did not expect to get Liverpool. Okay, then the rest of you that are not involved in anything, go here. Everyone just go aggressive. From Dublin to Liverpool. They don't have enough ships to kill all of my troops, which means I win, I think. They landed and even took a port. Well, we'll deal with it eventually. Expeditionary forces from Germany. 49 divisions. You know what? Yes. Yes, we want that. I mean, they're going to take them back in a moment, but I can use them to get rid of these guys here quickly and easily. We'll also send the Germans over to Britain. Should I send the Germans over to Britain? Possibly. Hold on, guys. Hold on. You're good. Doing great. Yes, land there and kill them. And Cardiff is mine as well. You guys, take Cardiff. Moving out. And you'll go to Scap Flow once it's mine, and it is mine. They're actually sending a naval invasion to their own port, apparently. Or are they attacking from somewhere else? Doesn't matter. You're on your way. Go. And you're not going because... why? Risk. Right, we're there. What's our participation? 13%. Growing steadily. Manchester is mine. Right, we're getting some attrition, but it doesn't really matter. Cardiff reinforcements inbound. And there we go. Beautiful. We've also landed up north. Now, I'm not sure what happens if I send the Germans in. Will that be my war score or their war score? Which is why I'm not sending the Germans in. At least for now. Ah, bicycles. Doing so well. They're very fast. Large front offensive. Continue. Human wave offensive. The guys in Cardiff are not doing so well. And just as I said it, they started doing so well. Okay, I think Britain's ours. How long until it's done? Still quite a while. 20% war score. Yugoslavia joined ours. I do have some German troops I could send there. I could also send some my troops there, which will give me the war score. You. I don't think they'll do another naval invasion. They won't have the time. Go, quickly. About Britain? Almost done for. Beautiful. Beautiful indeed. Oh, and you, you're going to extend your garrison to all the ports we currently occupy. Croatia happened. You, take Plymouth. I like saying Plymouth. I mean, I also like saying Plymouth. What? Free France? Right for Croatia thing. That's fine. So pretty. We finished another focus. Oh, I don't need these dockyards anymore. I mean, finish the ones you're building, but not more than that. The bikes have nothing to do. Ride for ruin. 24%. Not bad. Not great either, but acceptable, definitely. To redo your orders. Do some heavy fighting. I wish I got more war participation, but this should suffice for some nice stuff. And perhaps will be enough to get the Dutch Channel to happen. Oh, Norway. I've sent troops to Norway as well. Well, too late now. We're nearing London. Soviet Union attacks Finland. Well, we're not going to get involved in that, are we? No. No, we're not. Landing craft. It's a bit late for that. Is it the end? 28%. Decent. And yes. Yes, it is the end. Right, what have you taken? You've taken Poland. How much can we take? Not much. Not much indeed. Let's reset. I suppose I could do puppets. I care to do puppets. It would probably be cheaper to do so. Let's puppet the Brits in Ceylon. This way we'll know if... No, actually no. Let's pass. The Germans have taken Denmark. They'll be going after France now, I think. Can I make the Dutch Channel a reality? No. Right, I guess we might need to use puppets. Should have puppeted them in the first round. Right, let's puppet Britain and France. And turn. Good. The Germans have not taken much. Now let's see. 76 for us, 60 for the Brits. So it is a bit cheaper. Okay, we want the Channel to be the Dutch Channel. This is the most important thing. 53 for them, 70 for us. Okay, good. If we cut the Germans off like this, we should not be able to access the center of France. Well, I would need this one as well, but it's a bit expensive. Okay, end turn. Did I click it? Yeah, the Germans have moved to Britain. Problem, but not the end of the world. Right, so if we surround France like this, it's going to be fine with the Germans. Now, to make it look better, I'll also take this bit. Now, UK. We want Wales. Kinda. Right, this will have to do for this round. France is safe, more or less. Let's take the rest of Britain, what remains. Now for some colonial positions. This will have to do for this turn. Okay, is there much left? Not that much. Let's pass once. And again. Let's wait until the Germans take something. Let's satellite British Malaya and British Raj. Well, just Malaya for now, I guess. And pass. And pass. Oh, did they take Raj? Pity. Now, France. No, France. Take some France. And there's a bit of Poland here. And a bit of Czechoslovakia. Here. Why wouldn't I take it? Of course I'm gonna take it. And turn. And done. Could have been better, but I think it turned out pretty good. Remember that the British Empire and the French nation here are both mine. What are we gonna do with it? Well, I'm going to annex them, of course. I'm going to need quite a lot of political power for it. And once I annex them, we'll have the Dutch Channel, the goal of this entire campaign. You guys, go home. I do have to annex them because then the color will be better. So I'll also inherit their fleets. Let's start with Britain. Start land lease. Here we go. Have all my convoys and all my guns. Okay, just convoys for now. I can also build stuff in their territory. Let's do that too to speed things up a bit. But this will now join the Axis. Oh, what the hell happened? France automatically annexed Vichy France. Oh, that's wonderful. I'm gonna get all of their stuff for free. Great. I didn't realize that would happen, but yeah. I need to gather up 300 political power to annex each of them. It's quite a lot. All right, I also have Dutch Malaya. Well, you can remain a puppet, just like the Dutch East Indies. We're gonna have a wonderful fleet once we annex both the French and the British fleet. Could just navally invade the United States if we want to. Now, this would be nice, but we need the political power, so no focus. Delivery of convoys complete. All right, I no longer need any of these submarines, and I'll be able to annex them in a moment. Once we have enough political power, the remaining few points will be handled with our factories building stuff in their territory. Now we just need 31 more political power. And the final doctrine. Now we could go after the Germans now, or after the Soviet Union. After anybody, really. We're quite powerful, but there is no need. Well, before we annex them, I should probably steal their manpower. How much do you have? Just 100,000. Probably not worth stealing. Let's leave it alone. What France? 500,000. I should steal that. And again, if I'm stealing one, I should steal from the other as well. It's only fair. So I'll just copy their infantry division and switch you guys to it. Right, manpower drained. Time to annex on the Brits. Looking good. France, it is your turn. Start lend-lease of some convoys. Oh, just got an achievement. Putting the raid on the Medway to shame. Medway? Okay. How wonderful is our fleet? I'm going to have to wait quite a while because I need 300 political power to annex France. Trotsky has been killed. Sorry to not show you the pop-up, but I forgot to talk about it when it happened. Let's build some stuff in France and in our own territory as well, of course. Best guns research complete. The French are cooperating with the communists. Interesting. Italy's going to attack Greece. Should we get involved? We shouldn't. The allies probably still exist because Canada exists, but they didn't find it prudent to defend Greece from Italy. Time to annex France. Let's make sure to steal their manpower first. Just 382,000. Not that much, but it is useful. Let's copy a French template. I inherited their expeditionary. Sorry, not expeditionary. In exile templates. I don't think I can use them and drain manpower. Actually, let's see. I flip you to a Norwegian unit. You're going to be using Norwegian manpower. The answer is I cannot flip you to that template, apparently. Okay, so we can't steal manpower from other countries like this. Pity. But what we can do is steal it from France. Two armies should be sufficient for French manpower to be drained. It's been drained. Let us annex France. Manage subjects. Annex. Alright. Now look at this. Isn't that nice? It's now the Dutch Channel. Or more precisely, all belongs to the Low Countries. We have 153 factories. We will have more in time as cooperation increases. We also have some territories outside as well. Lots of territories outside. So that is it. We have accomplished our goal. This is the Dutch Channel now. I'm going to end this video here. Let me know what you think and if you want to see a different path for the Netherlands. Now, the obligatory what would I do if I continued? The most profitable course of action would probably be to attack nationalist Spain now. They're pretty weak and nobody would defend them. Once that is done, we should probably help the Germans and Italians defeat the Soviet Union and take a huge amount of it. And from there, we can turn against our Axis allies. Or we could attack Canada now. We should defeat them relatively easily because we're very powerful and they're not. And once we have Canada, we can easily invade the United States because it's still early and the United States are not that strong yet. Once the United States are taken care of, we can repeat what I said before. So nationalist Spain, Soviet Union, Germany, Italy, and so on. And then the rest of the world. So we're very well positioned to take over everything. We could even take over the United States with an Order 66. How? Well, we have territory here and the Japanese will be attacking down here. If we get into a war with the Japanese and the United States get into a war with the Japanese, the United States would give us military access. Then I can just station troops in their territory, attack someone in South America who they're guaranteeing, and then they would die. So that's probably the most prudent way to do this. Get into a war with Japan, perhaps kill nationalist Spain in the meantime, but get into a war with Japan, get access from the United States, send troops to the United States, Order 66 United States, take out Soviet Union with Germany, take out Germany and Italy. Alright, and also defeat Japan in the meantime. But yeah, that's it, I guess. Let me know how you liked this video, and I will see you again soon. Goodbye.